How's everybody? God bless you. You can be seated. Thank God for His goodness and being our God.
Amen.
He's an awesome God, isn't He?
Yes, He is.
Yeah, just turn to a man and say, God is really good to me.
Really good to me.
Yeah, he's good to me. He's good to me.
He's good to me.
He's good. He's good. Sometimes that's all I can say, He's good to me. But we do honor the Lord. We thank God for being our God. It's so good for us to be here. We thank God for Pastor Reeves and his wife and family. God bless them. Youth pastor, we thank God for, amen, for him. And thank God for all the young people. And of course, my daughter. Thank God for all those that are pastors and leaders. We do really give God praise for him.
Amen.
I love to see God move in the midst of his people. God is an awesome God, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I really do. I love God with all my heart. I'm saved to the bone. I'm saved. I love Jesus. If I can share a scripture with you, I know she said she, you know, I didn't come to preach, but if I can share a scripture with you, this is the scripture in the book of St. John, the 10th chapter. It's like the 34th and the 35th verse. Jesus says to his disciples, he says, a new commandment that I give unto you. A new commandment. And he says, the new commandment is, listen to this, this is really good. He said, the new commandment is that you love one another as I have loved you.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Now remember the old commandment was this, the first one, the promise. It says, love the Lord thy God with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, and all your strength. And then the second one, like I did the first one, says, and love thy neighbor as thyself.
Hallelujah.
But Jesus said, I'm giving you a new commandment. I don't want you to love your neighbor as yourself. I want you to love your neighbor like I have loved you.
My God.
How did Jesus love them? He gave his whole life.
Yes, sir. Oh, glory.
And I say this to those of us. The next verse says, before I finish and pray and take my seat, the next verse says, the 35th verse says, it says, Jesus says, and this is how all men shall know that you are my disciple.
Right, right.
How? Because I shout? Because I speak in tongues?
No.
Because I prophesy.
No.
Because I preach good.
No.
Because I play instrument.
No.
Because I'm anointed.
Come on, Bishop.
He said, this is how all men shall know that you are my disciples. He said that you love one another.
Hallelujah.
And I said to myself, sometimes we got to stop blaming the devil for everything.
Come on, Bishop.
Sometimes it's just us not loving one another.
Wow.
I'm talking about loving one another. Get in the midst of the saints and have a divine, agape love for one another. God encourages you and me as saints. Have this extravagant love for one another. I go out my way for you.
My God.
I lay down my life for you. Do you not know that anything you love, you don't talk about?
Oh,
if you love them, you don't want to hurt them. And the devil's job is to distort the love that we should have for one another in the church. So that's why he keep up mess, he keep up disturbance, he keep up divisions, because the devil knows that if we start loving one another like God loves us, he knows he has a problem.
My God.
And that's the only way people gonna know you're saved. People gonna know that we are his followers that when we start loving one another. In spite of their failures, love them.
My God.
In spite of our differences, love them. In spite of how bad they are, love them. In spite of what they went through, love them. And if you love me, then you won't talk about me. If you love our young people, you won't talk about the mistakes that they made. You'll go there and you will love them in spite of. So I say to you, God bless you, people of God. Thank God for you. And the Bible, the scripture really do teaches us about having this extravagant love for one another. And God said this, like this. He says, don't even say you love me when you can't love.
My.
God said, take your hand down. Stop telling me you love me if you can't love one another. Then yes. He said, amen.
Amen.
That's how the devil comes in, and he destroys us. He destroys our unity. He causes conflicts. He causes division. He causes, and everybody that say they love us don't love us.
Amen.
But it's not my job to try to make people love. My job is to love you. Hey, I owe you one thing.
Love.
I don't owe you nothing else, but I owe you love.
Yeah.
I'm always obligated to the saints, to the people of God, to love them, no matter what. I'm always in your debt. Every day I get up,
my God,
I got a
debt. My God, Bishop.
Love you. God bless you. Thank God for you. God bless you. Bow your heads and pray. Let us pray. We're going to ask everyone to rest on your feet. God bless you.